gentlemen, from the right to the left, you saw the four F-16 aircraft from the 906th Tactical Fighter Group at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base.
Machine gun and the Dragon anti-tank missiles. Just prior to landing, you will see the jumpers turn into the wind and prepare to land. Keeping their knees and feet together, they will execute a proper parachute landing fall to lessen the shock of landing. Upon landing, the paratroopers will place all weapons into operation, gather their equipment, and drive on with their airborne mission. Ladies and gentlemen, the Red Devils of the 82nd Airborne Division from Fort Bragg, North Carolina.
Flexible wires which provide structural strength or maneuverability during flight. It has a chain-driven wooden pusher propellers, just as the original model. It'll take off at just 41 miles an hour.
It would be hard to imagine a Dayton Air Show without Harold Johnson and his bright red Waco. The UMF-3, built in 1934. As you can see before you, Johnson is known for his love of vintage aircraft and his ability to rebuild them. Waco UMF-3 is the only one that's rebuilt it from scratch using a portion of the original fuselage and photographs of the plane itself. Johnson's skill as an aerobatic pilot plus his love of vintage aircraft provide air show spectators with a living piece of aviation history. Harold Johnson out in front with the MF-3. Down to the right hand portion now, the hammerhead turnaround. Right straight on up now, over the top. As Harold Johnson performs a six-sided loop. Coming in from the left. Now, you know, he doesn't use much airspace. He can keep that airplane right in front of him in a very, very small aerobatic box. Load the aircraft as it comes from our left to right. Harold Johnson up over the top, ladies and gentlemen, loading the aircraft now from the inverted back to the upright position. In the area besides Harold Johnson, that's Bob Wagner. The nearby Wright International Airport will be performing very shortly. Holding the aircraft on the upline now, right straight on up. Let the airplane slide back down in this nice tail slide before he breaks off. The airplane right straight on up. Hammerhead turnaround. Back down to the aerobatic box. Ladies and gentlemen, the 82nd Airborne.
Actually, a little bit later on in our program. Right now, Rob's getting very close to that opening altitude. He'll reach back, he'll deploy that pilot chute. As that pilot chute comes out, there you have the black and gold of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights.
And his wife, a former flight attendant. They have four grown children and five grandchildren. They divide their time between New Smyrna Beach, Florida, where he's associated with popular air centers. Clint now showing you how this Sukhoi 26 really operates. He goes to that vertical line. The roll rate, as I mentioned before, is unbelievable. He is the only air show pilot in the country right now in the United States that is flying this airplane. And he is really a great representative for it as he comes down and does a full roll one way down, then reverses that roll on the way down. It has a wingspan of 25 and a half feet, an overall length of 22 feet. The maximum load factor is plus or minus, I get this. Maximum load factor on this airplane is plus or minus 23 G's.
There is not a human being alive that could get half that.
You got that right. Nobody. Cruise speed is 143 knots. As Clint comes down, straightens that out. You notice how he keeps it well within the aerobatic body. Going into that vertical line, the sound of this engine is unique all in its own. It has its own sound. Comes across the top, does a series of aileron rolls. Has a fixed gear, very small wheel, low model plane. It absolutely astounded all the Americans when they showed up about 4 years ago in world competition with him.
They, in fact, the first year they had it, did win the World Championship. Now, the Golden Knights now have all packed up, picked up their gear. They're going out in the pickup truck. We'll give them a wave as they go by. Clint McHenry.
From down in Pompano Beach, Florida, New Smyrna, Florida, goes straight to the very glass. Look at the roll rate on that airplane, 360 degrees.
Drive, that goes faster than my mother-in-law talks, you know that?
Indeed. You know, it doesn't carry a lot of fuel, though, does it? The airplane will only fly for about 25 or 30 minutes, just enough time to launch, get in position to fly, fly the aerobatic show or maneuvers, and then return and land. Clint McHenry with a hammerhead, and look at that splat spin.
That's what they call the flat wing over wing gyro. See how he stops? You see the positive control he's got on that airplane?
Every instant.
But that is, when he comes off of that, that's what they call a pinwheel. It's another new maneuver that Clint was very instrumental in developing. You know, for the basic loop roll and the spin in the straight line, there are over 9,000 maneuvers available under the arresting system. Actually, the maneuvers are limited to the airplane and the pilot's ability. You can have a 900,000, I guess, if you wanted to. And quickly, he goes up on that 45-degree line, doing a series of quick flip rolls or snap rolls all the way around. These are very, very fast. And they call these flick rolls.
Just a flick of the hand on the stick?
Flick of the hand on the stick. You got it. Now, having completed the series of rolls there, he comes across the top, flies it over into one half cubic inch. He'll come down on that 45-degree line. Then he does. He hesitates. 2.5 roll on the way down. And let's give a round of applause for the Golden Knights as they're going down that flight line, ladies and gentlemen. And Clint McHenry going up on the 45. Now watch it, the lunge box, nose to tail. Tail for nose. Where it goes, nobody knows. And the Knights now headed down the round, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give them a round of applause. Put those hands together. Let them know how you appreciated their flight. Clint now going up to that vertical line once again. He'll hang it on the props. There comes the hammerhead stall. Straight down. Do you notice the controllability of that airplane as he flies it around the point? Now he just dives it down the ground to get that low altitude once again. He'll build up that airspeed as he goes to the vertical line. Now straight up. As he goes around, he starts to take that airplane and continuously roll it around and roll it around. This should be the torque roll. Now as it loses airspeed, it'll start to back up. It's still going around. Now watch it as it backs up. It still goes around. And it goes back one length, two lengths, three lengths. And there comes the flip-flop. You talk about a torque roll. He got a beauty. That is a torque roll that only like Clint McHenry could do it.
aircraft will now be ready in the aircraft carrier landing configuration. The Brubeck will be approaching from the right with his gear down, flaps.
Mr. Brubaker later on will demonstrate this approach on a carrier. You can see the tail hook hanging down behind the aircraft.
F-14
miles an hour.
Bill, you ever drive this
one
fast?
Third of its maximum speed.
Yeah.
From the left, watch now as he does the pop-up tuck under brake.
I see a camouflage hat. Camouflage hat's next to him. I can't tell if it's blue or not. I don't see it.
Yeah, camouflage. See it?
Yeah. Shit. Yeah, I see it.
Miramar on Saturday had the privilege of watching two squadrons of these come back from Mexico. Using full afterburner, he will then perform a dirty Immelmann, demonstrating the tremendous power and superb slow-speed handy qualities of the Super Tomcat. Watch this with carefully and listen for that raw, sheer power. You got a video here, and you got to turn the sound up. This will really add to it. All right, here comes the approach. This is what we call a missed approach on the carrier. He's down. He missed the wire. Go around.
Place, Ford Island, 235 Imperial Japanese Navy Air.
for the seventh morning.
What I can tell you is that I fear that all we have done is to have awakened a
together to put together this great air armada and finally to win victorious in 1945 over the Axis power. What a great, great airplane. The only other place you'll find that, two of them, bombay doors open. This aircraft known as the Texas Raiders. This aircraft was flying in the tour presentation. 1,200 horsepower on each side.
Ken, the pilot is Walt Thompson from Boston, Texas. Co-pilot is Buddy Cooksley from down in the Austin area. Flight engineer is H.M. Hancock from Houston. And the loadmaster is Mark Bitt.
Mark Bedford, Texas.
Yeah, we only got a first name on Mark.
Now listen to the sound of B-25. This one is from the Canadian Warbird Heritage. Here's the great Lancaster again, ladies and gentlemen. Listen. Engine. This airplane had over 2,800 horsepower. Listen, 16-foot propeller on the front of the aircraft.
We just want to let you know that we have a very secret stealth fighter in here. His little loudspot is going by on a taking a picture upside down. This is a photo mission. There's two Leo in there. You're going to see him flying a little later on. But I didn't want to think he had a new weapon out there.
Boy, you just never know what you're going to see at Dayton Air Show. Georgia girl, Twin Beech, Pratt Whitney R-90.
You'll get to a queen from Guadalcanal in the Philippines at the start of World War II to the hostile skies of Europe through miles of flak she flew. And home at 30,000, majestic as a queen, a silver bird flown by men, many in their teens. She carried war to the tyrant's lair to keep all nations free. She flew through flak and flame as far as the eye could see. She slugged
the horsepower and was a primary friend of mine. I jumped in to get the aircraft over in a big inside of Brian Stammer's loop. And very shortly, you'll be able to see the effects of the wingtips vortices. You should bring it up right in front of us now. Probably a half Cuban, or maybe he'll do a whole Cuban. See what's happening to those wingtip vortices when that smoke? Oh, rolling the aircraft to the upright now on the dyne line. The first half of the Cuban is powered sky good.
Now for the second half of the Cuban 8.8 on its side.
As it comes on the down line, I want you to roll to the upright position just about right here. So instead, you roll the aircraft to the upright position. The tyrobatic instructor for the Cuban Air Force under the regime of Batista. Oh. And Bob Ettinger driving a courtesy car from Hall of Fame Field Theater and his beautiful sailplane.
Again, a good chance you take a look at those wingtip vortices as it comes from our left to right.
On the upline now. There's one good control. And continue to roll to the right. Down the line, ladies and gentlemen. Tora, Tora, Tora. Ken Kreitz and his crew. Now take a look at those wingtip vortices, and how they will break up. Oh.
Major Dahlbeck is now repositioning his aircraft as he prepares to demonstrate the low altitude, high speed dash capability of the F-16 Lion Falcon. As he passes show center, he will be traveling at over 600 miles per hour.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big hand for Colonel Bob Ettinger? folks. We call that a tail slide. Stage left. Again, rolling out of the sky, building up the same kind of airspeed. I mean, right about now, he slams the stick over the side, hits rudder, and snap rolls, and we call that.
Cameras ready. We got two more sequences. Next one has got what we call, well, I'm going to tell you, it's kind of a signature thing. What we're going to do is give you some
more one when the Red Baron himself was out there hustling somebody to shoot at. You may have heard him before yourself. It may have been that way, but right now we ain't doing any shooting. We're just going to have a good time. Ladies and gentlemen, right back in that beautiful diamond formation, the Red Baron Stearman Squadron. What we're going to do is look on the way down. We're going to turn those airplanes directly away from you, 90 degrees, and we're going to split them up into twos, and you watch what you see. Back on the stick, up and over the top. Still maintaining about 1.5 positive G's. A beautiful sight. Now, ladies and gentlemen, a turn away from you, a 90-degree turn, and we do a 2x2. Again, we turn it into two air shows for a moment. This is shaped something like a heart most of the time. Sometimes it gets a little bit short on the bottom. But I'd like to dedicate this to all the ladies here in this beautiful air show. From the Red Baron Stearman Squadron.
Engines on this aircraft.
178th Tactical Fighter Group. Cargo loads in and out of combat zones, and has proven to be really robust and providing airlift support all over the globe. Watch now the C-130 in the short field takeoff. Continue to suppress that enemy fire while the C-130 is leaving.
pass.
Pilots and crew of the Charleston C-130 are Major Herbert Smith Jr., the pilot, and Lieutenant Colonel Joe Howes, the co-pilot. National Guard in Birmingham. The OH-6 plays a vital role in today's armed forces due to its maneuvering ability and... Pilot in command of the map. Also the Apache... And from the right, in the salute fingertips formation for you from the
aircraft to 170 miles per hour. Incline to an altitude of 50 feet. He will then roll his aircraft 360 degrees with the landing gear extended. The dirty roll on takeoff.
Head on, Mark. Head on. Got him?
Nah.
It's direct on.
Now, directly before you, the Blue Angels, 1991. As they approach, watch our two solo pilots detach on signal from Commander Waldrich and set up for the first of their opposing maneuvers. Thank you.
from the left. The Blue Angel, double cargo. Maneuver demonstrated by our two solo pilots. Approaching from the right, Lieutenant Seaman and Lieutenant Foley have established a mirror image formation. But look closely for both aircraft in a carrier landing configuration as they approach for maneuver we call the Fortis. Crossing over center point in the inverted position. The opposing 4-point. Hesitation roll.
Left. Oh, shit, you got him.
Maneuver. The opposing horizontal rolls. The maximum stick deflection horizontal rolls.
Air Force.
Good shot there.
From the right, at 400 miles per hour, the Delta roll. All five wingmen maintaining position on the leader as they roll their aircraft 360 degrees over center point. Over the top, you get a plan form view of the Blue Angel Delta formation. Towards the flight line. You should be able to follow the individual smoke trails as all four pilots converge on center point with maximum speed and minimum separation. handling characteristics of the Hornet in a clean configuration. He will pass before you, virtually standing Blue Angel number 6 on his tail. At less than 120 miles per hour, this state-of-the-art flight controls provide slow speed handling, second to none. Home based in Pensacola, Florida.
Missing man formation.
Here's the
focus right down here.
What?
Ladies and gentlemen, the United States Navy Flight Demonstration Integration Squadron represents a time-honored tradition of pride, professionalism, and excellence, spending 80 years
here
of naval
right
aviation.
Okay. If I push this button, it will go, right? There's a green light on.
It's going now.
Don't
push.
Maintenance crews and support personnel everywhere. From the right, the Blue Angels, 1991.
There, see
him? I don't see him at all, Martin. Yeah, I see him.
And adjust the power to maintain the proper rate of descent for the optimum touchdown point.
That's why I saw something.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, Commander Greg Waldridge. Flying Blue Angel number 2, the right wingman from Omaha, Nebraska, Lieutenant Commander Lee Gron. Flying Blue Angel number 3, the left wing man from Southern Pines, North Carolina, Lieutenant Pat Rainey. Flying Blue Angel number 4, the slot pilot from Memphis, Tennessee, Lieutenant Commander Dave Inman. Line Rainbow Angel number 5, the lead solo from Fort Washington, New York, Lieutenant Matt Seaman.
Go! No.
thus far.
Yeah.
That's real good, girls.
This was used for planning purposes, as you say.
Involving divergent ideals and ideologies.
Denny, make a couple copies.
How long will you come to the...
Thank you. Please turn on the lobby information desk.